Hello everyone, welcome to Imprint IAS. I'm Varun Khullar, and today we are going to look at geography questions from UPSC General Paper 1, 2018, right? So let's start with the question. So the question was, what are consequences of spreading dead zones on marine ecosystem, right? So now, first question you should ask yourself, why has this question come, right? So the first thing is, why asking me this question? Right? So the reason would be maybe this question in UPSC prelims. So which of the following have chunk dried up in recent past due to economic activities? And you can see the example of the RLC, which I made sure that you can see. So this is the RLC drying up. Now, what you can see is that the RLC is looking a little different. One is obviously the water has dried up. The other reason you might see is there's some kind of a green tinge to the water. Now, what is this green tinge? Okay, so maybe that is the question they're going for. And this is the dead zone. Okay, this is the dead zone they're talking about, marine ecosystem. Now, the question would be, how does the dead zone happen? The other reasons for the right, the question might be the three articles which have come in the Hindu across the period of 2-3 years. The greatest article, this article came in May 2008. Okay, there are other articles which are there. We'll put these articles in descriptions. You can look into that, right? Okay, now the question. What are the consequences of spreading dead zones on marine ecosystem? So dead zones are hypoxic, low oxygen areas in world's oceans and large lakes caused by excessive nutrient pollution. So this is the keyword that you have to mention in your answer, right? From human activities, coupled with other factors that deplete the oxygen required to support most marine life in bottom and near bottom water. Okay, right. So how do the dead zones, you know, actually occur? Let me explain this. So let's assume this is a piece of land, okay, and here we have, right, and here we have some crops and we have some trees, okay. Don't mind my drawing. So assume there's a river here passing through, okay, and there is a lake here, okay. Now this is land and you're doing agriculture here. What happens to you when you do agriculture? Very simple, you use fertilizers. And in time, what will happen? The phosphates, because you apply phosphates for fertilizers, they will go into the river and this will become NPK rich, right? And this river will flow into a lake, let's say, or an ocean. And right, so let's assume this is an ocean. And what will happen here? Algae bloom will happen, right? And this will basically turn green. This area should turn green. It's looking red, but okay, it will go turn green, right? And what will happen here is that with the algae bloom, in time this algae will die, and then bacteria will eat the algae and also absorb the oxygen inside here in the water. And the fishes, you know, let's assume there's a fish here who's living in the in this water, and this fish will no longer, right, have enough oxygen to live, right? And even if it and some fish was living maybe some far away and comes near this dead zone, it will just die, okay? And we have many examples. So obviously there are examples in the Baltic Sea, in the Gulf of Mexico, right? So so typically the reasons for deoxygenated areas are algae blooms, as I've told before, triggered by nutrients that can remove oxygen from water. Then nutrients runoff, fertilizers, runoff, sewage, animal waste, atmospheric deposits from burning of fossil fuels, etc. Right? And low oxygen levels make it difficult for creatures to survive. Low oxygen levels make it difficult for marine creatures and habitats to survive. Right? And obviously reasons are obviously lack of water mix, like in the Gulf of Mexico or in the Baltic Sea. And here again in the Black Sea and the Caspian Sea as well. Right. Okay. Examples. Obviously, there's another example is the Caspian Sea, and you can see the dead zone here. These are the dead zones, and you can actually see this. These are closer to the areas, and you can assume that why this is happening, because obviously, you know, a lot of NPK is coming from here, And then we have algae bloom, and in time what happens, the algae typically dies and the bacteria takes over and absorbs all the oxygen from the water, and in time there's no fish, right? So so fishes no longer live. Consequences, obviously, leads to reproductive problems in fishes and decrease in the size of reproductive organs, low egg counts, lack of spawning, right? It's an invisible trap, and there's no escape for marine lives, right? And once a fish wanders into a dead zone, it's hard to escape, right? So again, this is a huge problem. Then obviously lobsters and clams are obviously slow moving, and then they're unable to get away, right? So it typically destroys the marine ecosystem. And fish suffer greatly, as the level of oxygen changed their entire biology, and their organs typically become smaller, and you know, they no longer can actually do their natural functions that way. Way forward, obviously, maybe organic farming is the way forward, but obviously we really can't expect that. So better practices and accountability must be put in place to protect the ocean. A major step would be to stop letting so many chemicals find their way into the ocean. Major runoffs should be prevented. What we require is that whenever we recognize a dead zone, I think we need to very quickly make sure that, you know, something has to be done to stop that. Okay, right. So thank you so much. Like, comment and subscribe our channel. Visit our website. Also go through our Facebook page. Write and answer this question, and write to us, write the solution, and we can give you feedback on it. Thank you so much.